Hello, in this episode of my Beginner's Guide to Working with Todoist, I'm going to show you 10 tips and tricks that you're going to find very, very useful when using Todoist. Some of these tricks are my favorite tricks of all. Some of them, I just know that when I started out using Todoist many, many years ago, they were just wonderful to discover. So what I'm gonna do this week is I'm gonna save you all that time and I'm gonna show you just in one video, all these 10 tips and tricks that you can use to get the most out of Todoist. And I'm hoping some of these are just gonna blow you away. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, and I'm sure you will, please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Todoist now, my demo account, and I will show you 10 tips and tricks on using Todoist. Okay, so let's get started with the first tip, which is you can change the text formatting inside your Todoist. So one of the things I used to use was what I would describe as a reminder task. So to bold a task, all you need to do is either 2 stars or 2 exclamation marks. Now I'm old school, so I'm using 2 exclamation marks. So I can type in reminder and then close it with 2 exclamation marks and buy more coffee. So when I add the task, you see that this reminder is now in bold. You can also do star. Now I've got to try and remember this. Is it 2 stars for the reminder? So I can put reminder. Actually, the way I used to write it was I used to do it this way. So I'd put it in square brackets, reminder, buy more tea. So again, it worked. Why did that not work? Now I show you why that did not work, because I didn't close out the stars. So if I just go in there and put 2 more stars, that will now work. There you go. You see, that's how you do it. You can also italicize a task. Now I'm going to remember how to do this. I should have checked. I think it's 1 star. So let's just see. And we'll do the square bracket reminder. Close square bracket star, I think. Let's see. Add task. Yes, there you go. Yeah, so you can actually do a little bit of formatting of text by just using those symbols. So if we go into the top one, with your bolding, you do have a few options. You can go exclamation mark, that will bold it. Or you can use the asterisks. So if we just go into the edit here, you can see I've asterisked that one there. And single asterisks will give you the italics. So there you go. There's a way of being able to change your text. So something I didn't show you in the section when I was doing on tasks, you can actually use quick reminders. So let's say that take dog for a walk. I'm really not being very creative with my task today. So when do I want to do that? I want to do that today. So I'm going to type in today. You'll see that that is now highlighted. And the day section is, today is there, the date section. This is going to be a very important task. So I'm going to put P1. Oops, space P1. That now gives it a flag of P1. And I want to give it a label. So I'm going to hit the @ sign and that's going to be a chore. And there you go. Once I hit return or add task, that's going to give me the label. It's going to give me the date and it's going to take the dog for a walk. So you can use these little shortcuts. So let's just go into this. Can you see it? If we just go into there. No, you can't see it because it's already added. So again, if I wanted to add another label, I can just hit the @ sign. That will give me a label. If I want to give it a project, I can just hit this the hashtag. And that will bring up my projects. Now, as I showed you in the previous episode, we were actually creating sections. This symbol here means a section. So be very careful. If you actually have a project with a section that has a similar or the same name, you can very easily put them in the wrong place. So just be very careful. As you see, I've got a section there and I've got these sections down here. So that will help you to be able to put tasks in their rightful place directly from the inbox when you're working. So there you go. That's all to do with a little few what I call like the tips and tricks that you may want to use. So, okay, that's one. Okay,
how to use links in a task. So now the thing is, Todoist will give you an option to be able to add a link to a task. So I've got my blog post here about the time sector system, and it gives you all the details, by the way, if you wish to learn more about the time sector system. It is available on my blog post. Now, what you can do is you can hit the command, you can copy the blog link. So I'm going to copy the link, go back to my Todoist, and I'm going to add a task. Now, the thing is, what you do is you paste it in, and then if you open bracket or parentheses, if you're from the US, so in England we call them brackets, and I can type in read this blog post, which I highly recommend that you do, and then close the bracket. Watch what happens when I add the task. The task is no longer a long list of, so if I actually go back in there and edit it, you'll see that this task looks absolutely horrendous. It's very long and it's not very clear what it is. But because I've put the actual text in brackets here, I now have a section called read this blog. So when I click on that now, that is going to take me to the blog. There you go. It's opening up the blog, and sorry, my Chrome was a bit slow there, but it opens up I clicked it three times and it's opened up three times up here. But you can see that it's opened up the blog post for me there. Now, while we are in Google, let's go back to my home. Let's see if I can get to my Gmail. Do I have Gmail? So let's go into Gmail. I want to show you something in Gmail. This is a really, really good trick that you can use with Gmail. So let's just zoom out a bit here. Boom, 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 boom. Let's zoom, right. So now let's say I've got an Action This Day folder, which I do here. I've got an Action This Day folder. Now my Action This Day folder is very important. These are the tasks that I must complete or must do today. What you can do is you can copy the link to the actual Action This Day folder, go back to your Todoist, which is, I've got my Todoist here. I'm going to add a task. I'm going to paste that link in there. Then I'm going to add space, and I'm going to type in clear my Action This Day folder. Close brackets and add the task. Look what happens. First of all, I get the actual icon here, which is telling me it's an email. And what I can do now is let's just close that right now. So now, see, it's closed. It's not there. I'm going to close this one here. I'm going to close this one here. So just to show there's no cheating going on here, what I do now is if I hit that now, that's going to open up. It's going to ask me to sign in. Well, there you go. If I hadn't been signing in, that would have opened up my Gmail Action This Day folder. So there you go. And unfortunately, now I've closed out Todoist. Let's go back to my Todoist. So there you go. That's how, if I had been logged into my account, actually, because this is my demo computer, I very rarely log in. That's one way of quickly getting to your actionable email. You can actually do this for your inbox, of course, but if you're doing your inbox and you're not very good at managing your email, why would you want to go there? So there you go. That's another way that you can do things for yourself. Now, here's another one for you. If I've got a list of tasks like here, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tasks here, 6 tasks here. I can now copy these. This is just in a notes app. Copy. So I copy that list. So I add a task. And then I hit paste. It's now going to ask me if I want to add 6 tasks. I'm going to add those 6 tasks. And look what happens. They all come in as separate lines, all ready to go directly into my Todoist. So there you go. That's a quick way of getting a long list of tasks into your Todoist. So again, what you do is you copy those tasks. You go back to your Todoist and go add task and then click V. It will then paste it. You'll ask you if you want to add the 6 tasks. You click yes. There you go. All those tasks are now in my inbox. So there's a really quick way of adding tasks to your inbox. Now, what about creating templates? Now, people have asked me about this before. Todoist actually has some interesting ways of creating. Let's go into my projects here. So you can create templates various ways. So for some reason, I've got 5 things in here. But let's just say that this particular project here, I want to create as a template. So you can go over here to the 3 dots to the side, and it will say export as template. You click on that. Now you can do a couple of things here. You can export it as a file, or you can export it and get a shareable link. So if you export it as a file, you get a CSV file and you can save that wherever you want to go, wherever you want to put it. If you export it as a shareable link, what Todoist will do is they'll give you a link that you can copy to your clipboard, and then you can save that in your notes app, for example, and every time you want to come back to that project, all you do is copy that and then you paste it in, and that's a way of getting your projects into your Todoist. So you can actually create a template. But there is another way. If I create it, as you remember in the previous episode, let's say I've got one here called my morning routines, and I want to copy this every day because I want to create a new morning routine every day. So what I can do is I can go to the three dots here and say duplicate section. And look what happens. It's duplicated the section. So I can delete these off in a morning like this, and now it's done. And I've got the next day's morning routines ready and waiting to go. So there you go. There's a quick way, a very simple and quick way of creating a template. You can do that with quite a lot of different things. For example, if you do like I do, YouTube videos, and you have a checklist, you can just create the checklist, and then before you don't want to be deleting those, but before you delete them off, you check them off, you actually duplicate the task. So there's another way that you can do it. Now, something else that I really, really like about Todoist, particularly if you're working in one of those companies that has very strict security arrangements, what you can do is you can arrange to have your tasks for the day emailed to you. So if you go into general, I can't remember where this is, but let's just go down to the bottom. There you go. So you get a daily digest. If you click on that, send me a daily agenda, this will then send you email you your tasks for the day directly to your inbox. Now, I got to remember to turn that off because I get the email every day. I don't need it. But if you're working in one of those companies that has very strict security and you can't have your own apps, then you can at least get your list of tasks to do today emailed to you every morning. And that's a really useful one, as I say, if you don't have access to your tools while you're working. Now, if we got a feature in Todoist called Upcoming. Now, I haven't spent that much time with that in this series, but one of the ideas behind the Upcoming is you can move your tasks around. So, for example, I'm going to review tasks for appointments. I'm going to move this one. I don't know where these come from, but I'm going to move that over to there, and I take the dog for a walk. Okay, I'm going to do that tomorrow, so I'm going to drag it down to tomorrow. And what you'll see is I can move tasks around. So I'm going to take my dog for a walk on Saturday. He's going to be desperate by Saturday. But you can move these tasks. I'm going to buy his medicine on tomorrow. So when you're doing a planning session, you can actually go into your upcoming view and just drag and drop your tasks around, and they will automatically change the date for you. Now, one thing that's not unique to Todoist, but I think is very important, let's just get rid of some of these. This is a demo account, it doesn't really matter, so I'm just going to get rid of these. So what we want to do is you need to be very careful about how you create your tasks. Now, one of the tips I've shared many, many times, but I'm sharing with you here, is always start with an action verb. So it could be something like call, it could be like follow up, it could be write, it could be create, although that's a bit woolly because create is not kind of definitive. But things like call, follow up, write, and even like buy and do, you start your task with those kind of verbs. What you need to be remembering is when you're collecting the task, you know exactly what you're collecting. But let's say in 2 weeks' time, you look at something and you've just got something like Jeff. And you think, well, what does that mean? What do I mean about Jeff? So what you want to be doing is something like call Jeff about. So you want to be very careful about writing your task. So call Jeff about next week's golf match, for example. And now if that comes up in 2 weeks' time, you're going to instantly know what it's about. But I see so many people who might write something like Jeff golf, and I think, well, what does that mean? Now, when you write it, of course you know what it means, but what you're doing is you're writing when you're at your intelligent self. So you need to be thinking about your dumb self when you actually see the task. So be very careful about how you're writing tasks. Use an action verb. Now, if your language is very similar to Korean, where the verb comes at the end of the sentence, then again, you just need to be very aware of that. So with Korean words, we tend to put the verb at the end of the sentence rather than the beginning of the sentence. But you can still make sure that your tasks are action orientated and contain enough information for you to know exactly what it means. So that's another one that you want to be thinking about. And finally, number 10, what I want to do is I want to show you a way of gamifying, if you like, gamifying your productivity. Now, this isn't for everyone, but you can actually go into this section here where it tells you your productivity. Now, today, being this my demo account, I've actually now completed 23 tasks, where, hey, that's more than I normally do. On a weekly basis, you're going to see that last week I only completed 3, I completed 11, and I completed 1. So you can go into your what we call karma points. So here is your karma points. So as you can see, I don't have a very good trend, but I can now go into my karma goals and settings right here, which is in your settings section, and I can change these. I can change my goals to, like, I want to do 10 tasks a day. And my weekly goal is going to be 50, for example. I can also take time off. So Saturday and Sunday, if I don't make it, doesn't really matter. And you also can turn off your vacation mode. And the idea by karma streaks is that you get to move things forward. You get to gamify your actual productivity. And you can see how you're doing throughout the day with this check here. So obviously I've got 10 today and I've done 23. So I've already hit it. But you will see an indicator here as to how many tasks you've actually completed, and it'll show you how close you are. It's kind of gamifying productivity. And as I say, it's not for everyone. I don't particularly use it or pay that much attention to it, but I know some people do. And one quick tip about doing your tasks from using the karma points, what we'll do is, as you can see here, the top part, beginning of this part, is blue, and then it's gray. Now, gray indicates I'm completing from the inbox. Blue, because my home project is blue, is completing from my blue project. If I go into my work project here, and I check off these tasks, like write report, and then I can go back into my karma points, you might be able to see a little bit of blue. So as you can see in my completing the last 7 days, for today, I now have some red, which is my work, and I got some blue. So you can see where you're spending most of your time in the day via your projects. So there you go. Those are 10 tips and tricks that I think you might find very useful in Todoist. Hopefully you'll find some of them, if not all of them, useful. Now, thank you so much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.